And that's our co-founder in Earth Odyssey, Yuri Sanada, who has spent a lifetime of innovative sitting in Sao Paulo in Brazil. Yuri, you have the floor.
Well, thank you, Dr. Mahendra. I'm gonna try to share a video. Since you spoke about the video, we are doing a project next year that can may perhaps illustrate what we're talking about here. By the way, thanks everybody. I learned a lot. Let's see if I can share this video. Okay, we do movies for cinema, for TV, some documentaries. And what we're doing next year is we're starting a project on the Amazon River. And we want to engage the youth, we want to engage the schools, and we want to show them that learning and saving the planet can be a big adventure. So next year we plan to travel the whole Amazon River from the source, the new recent found the source in the Andes, all the way to the Atlantic Ocean. And that will be a scientific team traveling with us. But the main thing is going to be using these clean energy boats powered by the sun and by paddle, and built with bioresin and with natural fibers, hemp and flax and other stuff. So we're going to use this expedition, this project that is going to be turn into a TV series, into a movie, IMAX movie, into a learning experience. We intend to engage schools around the world, and they join us and they participate in our little expedition of 6 months on the Amazon to learn about the biodiversity, the necessity to preserve this amazing ecosystem, and how, if we destroy the Amazon, we're going to be destroying the world. I mean, there's no recovery if Amazon is gone. It's going to change the climate all over the world. So basically, I just want to say that we are trying to make a project that can really transform people, the way they think, and the way then and show them possibilities. For instance, that boat we showed, that little slide, and that boat, we're going to be sharing the technology with indigenous and riverside communities, so they can learn how to build their own solar boats and paddle boats, and they don't have to use gasoline anymore. That's very expensive and hard to get in the Amazon. So we can engage the schools and engage the youth and show them transformation is possible. But I think like this example, we have to do that, like somebody said here, we have to activate them using adventure, using something that they really can relate to and really can get them engaged. And I think like most of the people love adventure movies, adventure stories, the project has to do with adventure. It has to be like effort, say, we are, of course, a metaphor for what we're trying to do. We are a spaceship, this whole planet. We're traveling together. We are crewmates on this planet. We're traveling to the universe, both in space and time. And if you don't learn how to preserve our planet, how to maintain our spaceship, we are going to be destroyed. So that's what we try to do for next year and on Earth, show people how they can, especially the youth, how they can keep good care of their spaceship, this system that is suitable to maintain our life. Because if you destroy it by greed or for just ignorance, then it's all gone. Then we won't have a spaceship anymore. We won't have a planet. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Yuri. You need to add that we should take a delegation of youths, 12 or 16 for the paddle boats, because they will have the energy to paddle.
Yes.
While you make the video on this trip. So I think we should start thinking about two representatives from each continent or whatever, a formula to have a youth delegation on board.